Hey everyone, Zass here for another Vintage Cube. Looks like 14 undefeated trophies for the winner. It's pretty nice. Let's see what we open. It's always the first pack is so exciting. Player six, okay. And here we go. Recording. Yeah. Huh. All right. Not a fantastic pack. There's Emrakul. If we want to go for like channel or something unfair. There's like Carry Added, which is a fine start for a fair green deck. Dimir Signet's also just good because it's a Signet. And Glenalundra is just a very good card. Well, the biggest upside is Carry Added, but I feel like let's take the Signet. I think it's the most flexible and powerful. There is a Blightsteel, Emrakul, and Blightsteel. That would have been a start for something. Tinker or something. Frost Titans, very strong. I like him. Yawgmoth's Will, Ponder, and Ponder is just a very good card all around. Do I want to go kind of for the big Blightsteel cheat deck? Nah. Ponder seems like it might just keep me the most flexible here. I do like Frost Titan, but there's other strong finishers at this level, and Ponder's very good. Okay. Now that's a Sower. I like Sower a lot. Okay, starting to shape up to be a nice blue deck so far. This is all sort of Legacy Cube as opposed to Vintage Cube, but yeah, can't complain about these three cards. And having third pick Sower, I think, is a nice sign. Good shell for Recurring Nightmare. If we get that. Well, here there's a Power Stone and a Coercive Portal. I also Dig Through Time. I think the Power Stone is the highest highest upside here. I really like seeing that this late. This kind of deck, you know, maybe can power out a big Planeswalker. Signets really make such a difference when you have them. Speaking of Signets, there's three Signets. And a Gideon. And no blue cards. Maybe we just take a Signet here. So I think black and white are the most likely to splash with blue. and black is good since I already have the Demir. So yeah, let's take that. Well, there's a Supreme Verdict, which might be really what I want here. Have some white to go with it. There's also Inky, who's quite strong as a win con. If I get Tinker, I'll be sad, but I mean, taking Inkwell just to hope for Tinker seems a bit thin. Let's take the Verdict. That's the disciplined pick instead of the wishful thinking pick. Okay, so not seeing a lot of blue here. So we will have to fight for it if we want to continue under this road. Guess we'll just take the... Do we take Necromancy? Now let's take the Badlands on the sideboard. Trinket Mage. Versus Mana Tithe. I like Mana Tithe. Big fan of that card. I find the Mana Tithe and Force Spikes are very good in this format. People tapping out for big stuff. Even like late. Pretty late game. It's just bad when it's like top deck mode, but even up to like 6 or 7, it's good. Caryatid came back. Interesting. I was considering taking that. So... we take Blood Crypt, we've got a Nicol Bolas shell. man, I don't find Blade Splicer to be that great, but let's take it, just have a creature. Okay, I can see Ravages of War. Go for a Cheon build, blue-white control. Okay, I'll go for the Throat. And yeah, Reflector Mage is a nice, happy pickup. Here, do I go Braids? Okay, maybe Braids? Let's put that on the sideboard. Sure. Okay, a bit of a random start here. Ooh, Mox Jet. That is a Mox Jet. Well, just the fact that it's a Mox, I think we're taking it. Not a fantastic pack otherwise. Preordain's good. Jace is alright. Sure, we'll just take a Mox. Oh man, this is a great pack. Library of Alexandria. Opposition. Metamorph. Skull Clamp. Wow, what great cards. Well, I think it's going to be Library of Alexandria. Put this along with... Well, we'll keep the Monks. Okay. There's a Sword. And Geist. I like me Geist. And Hero. This is a nice pack. Maybe we take Geist here. Yeah, maybe it's Geist, and then we see if we can wield the Hero or the Sword. Maybe I'm going back to wishful thinking and trying to get the same deck I had last time that I feel I misplayed. But I do have fun playing this kind of deck. So yeah, let's take the Geist. Gear Hulk. Is Gear Hulk any good? Target instant card? Not that many instants so far. There's Declaration in Stone. Ral'Zarek, I don't really see playing. There's Maze of Ith. Fiend Hunter. It's just a creature, it doesn't work on everything, so I don't know if I like that so much. Man, that's pretty meh. I guess I'll take Fiend Hunter. I think he's pretty average. Ooh, Cryptic and Thada. And Ancient Tomb. Man, Ancient Tomb's so good. I think I. Oh man, that is brutal. God, Cryptic's fantastic, but Ancient Tomb is just such a kick in the butt. Yeah, I'm gonna take the Ancient Pit Tomb. It's so strong. Ooh, Force of Will. We'll take Force of Will. And maybe if we're lucky, we can wheel one of these cards. I think, man, I've had some nice Tinker targets here. Be sad if Tinker comes up. Ooh, is this gonna be a Lingering Souls deck? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I certainly can play it. Is that better than Monastery Mentor? I think it might be. Lingering Souls is really good. But so is the Mentor. Yeah, let's take the souls. Think they're better. Okay, Signet, another Signet. Big fan. But totally off color. Or Force Spike. I like Force Spike a lot. I'm a huge fan of Force Spike. Artifact or enchantment card. Yeah, maybe with the black, this is pretty splashable. Let's take Anguish Unmaking. Exile any permanent? Yeah. Ooh, I got my Metamorph back. I love my Metamorph. We'll take him. He's really a three drop. Hero came back. That's pretty nice. I wonder if we'll get the Spear of Heliod as well. No, but we've got the Declaration, which I suppose we can maybe sideboard. three free black splashes. Or white, much less so. We did get the spear and Thada. I think Thada's better. I like Absinthe a lot. Okay, if we put the jet, kind of as a land, we've got something so far. Ooh. Wow, great picks, great picks. This treachery is fantastic. Hollowed Fountain, which we need more than almost anything. Ugin, this is a really, really strong pack. I think Ugin is so good that I'm just going to take it. And damn the torpedoes. Ugin just finishes games. And we have Power Stone and two Signets. And we don't have like a big win con in this game, in this deck. Wow, Sol Ring. And Jace the Mind Sculptor. Huh. And Factor Fiction. This is a great... I must have had like Black Lotus in this pack. Well, we'll take Sol Ring because it's fantastic. It's a one power stone for one that comes into play untapped. And that's just about the best thing I can imagine. There's an on-color Signet. That's really hard to beat. There's Daze, but we have Force Spike and Mana Tithe. I'm going to take the Signet. Interesting. Interesting. Kind of like a control shell. Here. There's Path to Exile. I think where we're at with all these Signets, we're more like Planeswalker and Tamiyo, I think, is more fitting the niche here than the Path to Exile or the Westvale Abbey, which were my other considerations. So we're probably not playing Blade Spicer here. I think Hero is good enough to just play. Ooh, can we play Nicol Bolas? Can we? Double black. We've got the blue. And then red. That seems really greedy, I gotta say. And we'd be much better off with Muldrick, Drifter, or Caracas, to be honest here. Yeah, let's take Caracas. I've been just getting this card in like every draft, and it just does very, very well. Brimaz is another favorite of mine. Is Tezzeret good? Do I have enough artifacts? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I have 5 artifacts. No, that's not good enough. So it's going to be the Brimaz or the Jace. I do like Brimaz, but I think this is more of a Jace deck here. We want to draw into our Planeswalkers. Yeah. I won't be mad if Brimaz wheels. I mean, he's great. But I think this is a deck where We're just trying to ramp to like an early planeswalker or like hero or something. Okay, speaking, well, there's good choices here. There's Mana Leak, which is a fantastic counter spell. Part of me wants to take that. The other one I like is Gideon. I think the Mana Leak is better here. Yep. Gideon's not the most impressive of, or that version of Gideon is not the most impressive planeswalker. And permission spells are very strong. Well, here's another Gideon. And he's not bad, actually. Yeah, I think I like him better than Nykthos or something. Maybe not Fiend Hunter. Maybe not Thought of Main Deck. It's a pretty good deck so far. Some reasonable removal. Ooh, wow. Treachery and Hollowed Fountain. Good lord. Oh, man. I really need the Hollowed Fountain. But Treachery? Yikes. People in the comments, what would you do here? I think Treachery's too good. My mana will be bad. That's too strong. Okay, Vindicate. We'll put in the sideboard. It's actually just better than Anguished Unmaking, I think. Well, it is an exile instead of a destroy. Maybe that's better. Oh, man. I can't believe I didn't take that Hollowed Fountain. And here's another removal with Council's Judgment over Tar Pit. And we have Badlands, Mox Jet, Signet. I'm okay on the black. I think we take the Judgment. I know we're playing that, so against a fast deck, we can side in the Soldier here. Nicole Bolas. Okay, why not? Why not? Okay, this is going to be an interesting build. Munitithe for Spike Ponder. Mana Leak. Blue, white, blue. These act as sort of a kind of fixing. I know it's a bit iffy saying that, but they do. Well, these are all pretty strong cards. Do we try this in like 16 lands? What else are we looking at here? There's Thought of Adele and Vindicate are both, I think, strong choices. Got a lot of like one for one removal. I think this is better, just straight up better than Anguished Unmaking, though, right? Exile permanent. Exile permanent. Yeah, so this is superior. It's just like, do I want to add more removal? I can put these in. Like, if I'm playing against a lot of planeswalkers or something. Could also just take out Absent here and play these. Strong, this is all pretty strong. So we've got pretty few creatures, just the hero. The Sower, Reflector, Geist, and Metamorph, and then Lingering living souls as a creature. Okay, this is, it's a bit shady with absolutely no dual lands in white and blue, but treachery is so fantastic. And then we do have a random jet. And we have library. Can't forget about that. You got the black. The black, we've got jet. Orzhov and Dimir, so we're fine on that. And we have two colorless in this. We're really pushing the jankiness here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 white. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 blue. Okay. Definitely on some shaky ground here, but let's go for it. It's not really what I want to see. If we draw a land, then we're very good. Otherwise, we're in trouble. We can wait two turns without drawing a land, and then we'd have... Now we got a mulligan, because it would have to be a... Well, I think we have to mulligan. Well, that's just strictly worse. So we'll have to we'll keep that because we have the scry, though. Put this on the bottom. Ooh, he's got a library too. Okay, that sucks. Probably just going to be buried in the card advantage here unless we can draw land right away. Okay, we're going to play against some green cards. Yuck. Okay, well... I think we're just going to live. Pretty hard to beat. Oh, and he's an animator too. Okay. Well, I also have a library. With a Caracas. I hate to give it away, but, you know, gotta play it right away. And we'll play the Dimir Signet. So that in principle, maybe we can one day mana leak something. I think we need to just start playing out all our mana. One, two, three, four. So we can play Signet and then a Power Stone. Alright. Now we have lots of mana. Four, five, six, seven. So it can play like, I think it's with only blue, two blue mana symbols, it's more like play a hero and hold up Mana Leak or something. Mana Leak's not going to be amazing against an Awakening Zone. Maybe this is the deck to take out your four spikes against. Instant or sorcery, okay. So we can take my mana leak now. Weird that he buried alive for those three cards. Maybe he's got living death. Okay, that's a soul ring. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. So, might as well play a hero and a Jace, I think. Right. Can't avoid it, right? Alright. Super slow, but at least now he has to deal with us somehow. Guessing what? Buried alive? Buried alive would pretty much wreck me. He's gotta have something to deal with this. Great. And we can still play this. I think he's using his library now. So, do we just want to draw a card? What do we do? I think we want to just draw a card. Okay, that's not going to be super helpful. Here's where an Ugin would just be great. At least we'll get our hero back, and that's going to start doing some work. Mm-hmm. probably has an Emrakul. Should be counting mana. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He's close. Massacre Worm. Yeesh, okay. I think that's gonna put me in a bad spot here. I can still bounce the shoulder in. Because there's like treachery. So I think my best bet is actually drawing treachery here. Well, might as well use the mana tithe. Totally dead. If I draw treachery, I think I'm good. Well, no, because he's just then going to use Liliana. So I really need Ugin now, I think. Yeah. Ancient Tomb, that's not going to do it, but could still draw it. Reflector Mage. Target player control. Yeah, it doesn't really do it. As long as we don't die, we have an out, right? So let's play. Does this really do anything? Sure, it prevents a hit one time, I guess. So yeah, I think we're all in on just drawing Ugin now. Yeah. 1 in 22 chance. It's pretty low. Try for it? No, that seems crazy. Didn't really see too many artifacts. Do we want more 1-for-1 removal? I think we can take the tithe and the spike seem less good against him. Maybe we can bring in Vindicate and Unmake. Anguished Unmaking? Fiendhunter also seems good against him, but all right, let's try this. Several things that hit things like Liliana now. Not great for the Tamiyo, but I will keep this. At least we can play an Unmaking and a Signet. Okay, that's great. Tutor, scary. Scary, scary. Maybe he can like channel out some big Eldrazi and I can anguish it. Exactly what I wanted, but given my mana base, it is about as good as I can expect. Might as well represent a force spike of some kind. Ugin, where are you? Oh man. That is bad. So now we'd like an island to be able to tap down his stupid library. That's not it. So here comes Iona. I have to hope he hits blue here. That's a metamorph. Maybe against him we pick black. Yeah, let's say no black. Now we can still draw Caracas. The problem is we're still facing down the library here. That really shows the power of the metamorph. Do we block? I think we do not block. Ugh, that's bad. Alright, let's attack. I think just need to draw Ugin here. Can I take one more hit of this? Of course, now I feel like I should have gone for green, but he probably has everything. Alright. I'll just have to hold back and block here. Okay, now we have to trade and like draw blue and treachery the Hydra or something. I think I have to anguish this thing. I lose 3 life, that's really brutal. But otherwise, I'm just gonna die. So. Bad mana is bad. Yikes. Okay. Really need it in here. And that's not it. But I can play a Reflector Mage. And that gives me another turn for a treachery draw. Again, draw. If I draw an island, I can treachery his Massacre Worm. Or I can just Supreme Verdict. Destroy all creatures. And yeah, that won't work, right? So... and I can't chump, so I have to cast the Verdict. Oh no, that still happens. Okay. Alright, well, it was dead. First. Okay, we'll keep this. Can't cast our blue spells, but we have a Day of Judgment, a Council's Judgment, I mean. And hopes for a blue. Maybe I really should have taken that Hallowed Fountain over the treachery. It's tough, though. Treachery is like such a winning card. The Muffin Man. I feel like I've seen this guy's name before. Okay. I'm playing Island. That way we have the potential of, if we draw another blue, play Jace. Okay, we did not. So we can judgment whatever nasty thing he plays. Like that. Force of Will. All the blue cards. Alright, we'll just judgment that thing. Thank you. we can force. Something if it looks really bad. Kalidas, huh? Mm-hmm. That seems not that great. Mm-hmm. Rather try to sower that. Mm-hmm. Alright, let's play hero. So maybe I should have forced, I don't know. And I've got, what am I complaining about? I've got Caracas here. Let's just return this. Okay. Shriek Maw. Let's force of will that. Okay, Mana Tithe seems like that would be possibly useful. Can't cast Sower, unfortunately. Okay, so let's make sure we stack it right. First, we want to. The first thing we want to happen is have the tokens. Remembers the Mana Tithe. Reanimate on Shriek Maw. That's not good. Okay. Yep, that was a little hopeful to expect that the hero would just live. Oh man, this blue is killing me. Don't feel super happy with the way I drafted this deck. Okay, well, at least we have the Sower now if you play something really nasty. I want to keep the Sower for something better than this. Fear. Okay, I'm okay to take a hit. Let's see if you play something better. As long as he's not forcing us to cast our Sower here. Sure. Must have just forgotten. Why is he not attacking me? That's really weird. But okay, I'll keep waiting. Maybe he doesn't realize that. Intimidate or something? Okay, that's a problem. Yeah, I'm just gonna go quick. Why is he not attacking? Ugin. Awesome, okay. These are still white, right? White creatures. it's one or more colors. So we might as well attack. And attack him. Okay, I don't know how I won that. He simply just wasn't attacking when he could have. That was weird. Maybe we don't take Ancient Tomb and just add another island. Out of desperation here. And Anti-Tide was good. Strangely. I like Anguished for the Exile. Or like go for the throat. All right, let's try that. Okay, Library and Soul Ring, we'll keep this. So if we play library and draw, we're going to lose it. So I think what we want to do is play island, soul ring. We'll be at 6. No, that's not what we want. If we play island, then we're at 7. Soul ring, we're at 6. Then we draw next turn, we play library at 7, and it doesn't work anymore. So we just want to play library and use it on his turn, so we don't have to discard. Can play island. Soul ring. Tap to draw. And signet. Great. Lingering Souls, that's kind of good, actually. Did he hit that? Oh, but it hits the library, which is fantastic. Okay. Yeah, that's strong. Good, well played. So, option one is we just play Lingering Souls and just go back to library. 3, 4, 5. We're not really close to Ugin here. And we have Supreme Verdict if you play something really nasty. along with treachery, so I'm okay with just flashing back Lingering Souls. Oh, I messed that up. No, I didn't mess it up because I needed the black. It was the same sources for the mana type. Okay. Okay. So now let's draw. I like the idea of playing something for Mana Tithe here. I can't play the hero. I could play the Geist, but no, I'd rather just keep Mana Tithe up here and just like ramp Tortugan or something. Attack with one of these. Keep the other one on defense. Sure. Things get really bad. I've gotten verdict, hopefully. Ponder. Okay. Island. Let's draw a card. Okay. Suppose I could treachery the Kalidas and then draw another card. That seems good. So treachery Kalidas, I'm down to 7. I draw a card, I'm at 8, and I can ponder or something, or I can even just do it at end of his turn. And I still have Mana Leak up. And I have, let's do that. Let's see, we're at 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we're close to Ugin. Okay. Let's take a Kalidas. Actually, let's do it. In case he has Days. Keep the one for Mana Tithe as well. If he has, he could have Mana Leak, and then we can just Mana Tithe to protect the treachery. We did lose the Mana Tithe ability, huh? That was bad, I guess. Did I not need to tap that? That may have been bad. Okay, so I think we then hold it, and we'll just use it at the end of turn. My mana more intelligently and kept this up. What's he got? Reanimating my sower. Okay, well, not a lot I can do there. Spike. Okay, I'll just take it. That's actually a bit of a problem. Ponder for a land, maybe? So top, and then 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, right? So top, no. Play the jet, and now we can play Jace. Maybe we just play Geese. No, because we want to exile stuff. But otherwise, we're going to discard something. So, well, I'd rather have my mana for Mana Leak. So that's okay. We can discard something. So I want all this, I like this, like this. Also discard Jace of all things. Because with our library we're pretty good on the card draw. Now we have a lot of permission. Not Expector. Okay. So hopefully now I can just Ugin and hit at 4. Please don't count on me, bro. Okay. Well, this time I still don't have double white. Okay, and we can discard now, I suppose. I don't want to see the, what's the thing I care the least about. I like Tamiyo, I like Mage. I like Geist, Verdict, Hero. I suppose the mana type is the least good. Oh god. What is it? Karn, no. No. That's big problems. Exile target permanent. Okay, well we can at least force him to use the Karn, I think. Shoot. Well, we want the white. Huh? What happened? Did I just click through by accident? Oh no. That's awful. That's terrible. Oh god. Ugh. That's just, I don't even understand what happened there. Christ, okay. What's going on here? Really? I just... Oh my God, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So let's draw a card. So let's definitely play Geist. Okay, and then let's keep up Mana Leak, I suppose. The anguish I'm making on the Karn, which I think we'll just do. We still have Mana Leak. Do I want to tap out for Tamiyo? 2, 3, 4, 5. No. I just want to keep my Mana Leak around. And just like Reflect or whatever he plays. Ashiok. Fine. It's not the worst. Hero there. Let's attack first. Get Ashiok. We want to kill him, so. And then maybe we should, I'm okay with going back for more card draw if I need it with the library. Okay, let's draw a card. And okay. Well, one unfortunate click through, and then a lucky draw saved me from another possibly game-ending play. And we get one on the books here. And all right, here we go for game three. Actually, you know what? So let's look at our deck again. We've had such mana problems that I wonder if we want to take out Ancient Tomb and just put in an island. Yeah, I'm going to do that. And Maybe Go for the Throat just is not that great compared to, say, The Unmaking or Vindicate. Let's do Vindicate. It can hit lands. Two lands, so sure we'll keep this. And we have a ponder. Those all seem pretty bad. So we will shuffle. A supreme verdict. Okay. I did hit shuffle. This gives me an onion. Immediately, I think opposition when I see this land. Okay, that's lucky. Power Stone or Jace? Let's play the Jace since I have nothing really to Power Stone out right now. I'd really like to hit more cards. Force of Will, alright, let's draw another card. And a Tamiyo. Okay. Can at least force away the Supreme Verdict if I need. And we can represent Force Spike. Just have us both draw a card and play my Tamiyo. And I can still metamorph if there's something really scary. So, doop, doop. And I suppose. Blue, green, yeah, let's tap his, tap this. Frantic Search. Yeah, I guess you can Frantic Search. Remember, I can also force away the Reflector Mage. So now Tamiyo's a win con. Elspeth. That seems like something we'd like to force. And I think we will force with Reflector Mage. Let's draw a card. Lingering Souls. Not useful. prevent him from... This is his only black source, I suppose. Still double blue is opposition. Let's do that. Oh. I'm just confused. Okay. And now we're kind of soft to everything, but... Hopefully with all this double card drawing, we'll eventually draw a white source. Freylis. Destroy an artifact or enchantment. Okay. Well, that's going to be the end of my Power Stone. Okay. Come on, wait. All right. Do we care about the Freylis? We sort of do. But I'd rather just play Lingering Souls. Tap, green, green. Still keeping it on double blue. And now, don't care, if I don't care about Freylis, I can cast this for one. That. And then I can also flash it back, right? We can vindicate if something gets really bad. To hitting Tamio, but could certainly have something to deal with my Planeswalker. Judgment. So let's draw some cards. Soul Ring. That's a thing. I guess we can tap the elf here. And in case he has like a bolt or something, I kind of want to hit Freylis with everything. Just a hedge. But he could have. No. Let's keep one back in case. If he has some, like. Yeah, let's keep one. Just. What if he has, like, a Blood Braid or something? I'm going to be able to chump, you know? Have that, but you know, he could have done two to. No, I guess he couldn't have. Let's play Soul Ring here. Okay. Still feel pretty good. Threatening ultimate. Then we can start like Infinite Council's Judgment. Or Infinite Vindicates. Uh-oh. What is this? Karn? Grook Apex Predator. Oh man. How nasty. Ah, man. Shoot. That's frustrating. Okay, well. Alright. Maybe I just Ugin at 7 here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Draw a card. Now 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I can survive a daze. So let's attack first. That was a mistake, wasn't it? Because then I just lose everything. What am I doing? Man, that was really a mistake. And then if he kills a soul ring, can I not Ugin? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I still can. Boy, I'm playing loosey-goosey here. So I would, what I would like to do, yeah, is just play, is Judgment the Garruk and then play Ugin. That's what I'd like to do. So, okay, we made a mistake. So now we're going to lose our soul ring, presumably. Now what? Dragon Lord of Tarka. Another problem, okay. Ugh, perfectly kills everything. Okay, he made an elf. Okay, we can still go for a blowout here. Ooh, I can treachery and Ugin. But treachery, then he uses Frailes to beat it. It's just when it enters the battlefield. So I could metamorph, or I could just try to verdict. Ugh. I'd really like Ugin to survive. And I'd like to blow it at 5. So maybe what I did just do here is verdict and then Ugin. Or I can even take a hit. 8, 9, 10, 11. It's only 6. But I don't want him to draw all these cards. Okay, so we'll verdict. Why didn't I fin- and I can't also vindicate, so okay. All right. Now what? Stop playing things. His own Ugin. No way. Oh my god. Okay. So now we have to vindicate that. Please. Two, three, four, five, six, seven. I do not have enough for Ugin. And I can make another soul ring, but no. And let's see if he kills this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I still have just enough for Ugin. Okay. Yeesh. Stop playing all these. Just crushing. That's nice. At five. Mari's wake. Okay. That looks quite terrifying. Okay. Oh, four spikes gonna do, Jack. And why don't we play a nice little hero blade hold to put some pressure on. Or no. Five. Let's just ride you again, see if we can start drawing cards. Yeah. Nargos, it's fine. Okay. So I'll draw a card. And do three to yes. Planes and play a hero. All right. Sure. Thank you. Reputation. Let's draw a card first. Let's play a Sword of Temptation. What more nasty stuff do you have? You've got to be kidding me. Okay. Okay, so let's treachery his guy. Tapped mana wrong again. It's fine to draw a card. Let's play Geist. Okay, so please stop drawing all these cards. I'm just casting all these things. Oath. Okay, that's going to be one turn too slow, I think. That or ignore it. Cameo. Okay. Okay, so he's going to draw two cards. That's fine. Fury. Christ. I think the treachery, fine. Okay, that's fine. You can have the treachery. We'll bounce the Kozilek, metamorph that, and then hit him. Okay. Wow. Okay. So, I wonder if this is another one where Force Spike and Mana Tithe are not great. But Anguish seems fascinatingly good. So let's see. Unmaking, definitely. Did we really see any? You never pay attention if he's got artifacts here. I don't think I really saw. Yeah, he had Simic Signet and stuff. That was pretty weak sauce, I think. Yeah, maybe we just take Declaration in Stone here. Okay, got another library. So we will keep that. Let's play fast. As fast as we can for a library. Remember to do that on his turn. So we'll play Plains and a Soul Ring. Okay, Crocus will be quite useful. Let's play an island and then a signet. Yeah, but if we can hit Ugin, you know, I'm pretty happy. So 3, 4, 5, 6, we're two away. That sounds something I'd like to mana leak. Actually, let me cancel. Draw a card first. And now let me mana leak. Let's do like that. And now we're done. Play Mox Jet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Let's play Ugin. And remove 2. Judgment that and blow up his little guy. that'll start to get problematic. So just do it. Sneak attack. Terrifying? That is really scary. Okay, so let's just play Caracas. And let's just start. Oh yeah, and let's just minus that, because gotta get rid of that. Some bad news. Are you serious? God, every time. Okay. At least we have the verdict. So let's see if he kills the Udin. Six, seven. It's not that big a deal. Okay, I can take a couple hits. I don't really want to bounce it, because then he'll just recast it and take something. Scary. Good thing to verdict. treachery. Treachery sounds great. Still verdict and then souls. Stone, we got nothing of stone. It's just a creature. Okay. All got control magics and stuff. If we play super fast, that's going to be problematic. We just keep it as is. Absent seems very nice against him. Do we try to bring in? I don't think we have enough creatures to try to bring in. Play absent and take out I'm gonna play this instead of absent. Nah, we want absent because he's got a lot of planeswalkers. Take out. Good, that's very good. Your Flector Mage just isn't that good. Okay. You're gonna have to play fast. Mulligan, easy. Okay. We'll just keep that. We'll put this on top. I'm just gonna go for the quick Geist here. Just hope it wins. He might have mana tithe, so let's not risk it. Sounds great. Let's attack. He summoned his sweepers, right? Works. Don't have sweeper. Scary, scary, scary. Sneak attack. Oh my God, okay. Emrakul? Please no Emrakul. Okay. Wow. I don't know why you conceded though. Concede. Why did he concede? Because oh, because then he has to sack with the sneak attack on the Atarka, and then he gets hit. All right. Well, that was certainly an exciting game. I didn't think this deck was a 2-1 deck. I thought it was a pretty bad deck, but it did have maybe like more late game staying power than I give it credit for. You know, you can't really complain, I guess, if you have Ugin and Library of Alexandria, your deck can't be that bad. But yeah, thanks for watching. That was a lot of fun, and we'll see you next time.